The television talent shows Any Dream Will Do and How Do You Solve a Problem Like Maria have shown that our appetite for musical theatre is as strong as ever, and a new band just starting out is capitalising on that love for all things musical.
They're called Teatro and are made up of four dashing young men. You know exactly what it's like to appear on the stage. This weekend we'll see Jeremiah, Andrew, Simon and Stephen appear at the Royal Variety Performance. We'll be asking them about that in just a moment. First, let's have a listen to them singing Andrew Lloyd Webber's Music of the Night.
Floating, falling, sweet intoxication. Touch me, trust me, savour each sensation. Let the dream begin, let your darker side give in
to the power of the music that I write.
The power of the music of the night.
You alone can make my song take flight.
Help me make the music of the night.
And here they are, Jeremiah, Andrew, Simon, Stephen.
Very well.
Right. Absolutely.
Yeah, okay. That's a five each, you owe me.
Okay, let's start with Jeremiah.
Yes.
Very good morning.
Good morning.
Are you all? How did you all get together?
Well, you know, it was an organic process where we were brought together in a workshop process by our manager, Jonathan Shallett, who was Charlotte Church's manager for quite some time.
Yeah, that's right.
And brought her to superstardom. And so we worked through things, checking out different music and different voices and how we got along and blended. And we were the four gentlemen who were lucky enough to get together in the end.
Yes.
Jonathan was looking for four leading men from the Broadway and the West End,
So is that, in a sense, your unique selling point? Because there's an industry, if you like, of you're fantastic singers, marvellously good looking, but there's you and there's Blake and there's, what's it, Il Divo as well.
Yeah, yeah. Yep, absolutely.
So what makes you stand out from them? Because they're marvellous as well, of course.
Well, I think the main difference with us is we have one foot kind of in the pop door, really.
Right.
Well, the other guys are a bit more classical. I mean, fantastic at what they do, but I think, you know, as a foursome, we're a bit more poppy than the other groups that are around at the minute.
And Stephen, you've got a kind of musicals background.
Yeah, that's right. I think that was the general concept, was to try and find, as Andrew said, four leading guys that had an extensive career behind them, so that, you know, we hit the ground running and that we're already used to performing and being on the stage.
So what have you done? I mean, what is your musicals background?
Mine, well, I did West Side Story for a year, and then my biggest opportunity was the lead in Bombay Dreams, Andrew Lloyd Webber's Bombay Dreams. And we've all sort of come from that. Simon was a lead in Les Mis recently, actually was offered a role in Phantom and turned it down to be with us.
So
we're very happy about that.
So what was the draw of these guys over?
Well, I mean, once we kind of understood and kind of got our heads around the concept of the idea, I mean, it hasn't really been done before since the days of the Rat Pack. Mm-hmm. And it was such an exciting idea, and, you know, Teatro was just the ultimate choice for me in the end.
I think Teatro is the only group out there that are singing show tunes, musical theatre numbers, and it hasn't been done since the Rat Pack in the 50s.
So that's the distinctive feature is the musicals theatre.
Yeah. I mean, there's such a massive catalogue of music to choose from as well.
Yeah. And Jeremy, I can't help but notice you have a different accent.
This is true.
From the rest.
This is
true. Yes. That's right. That's the time. No.
So, what's your background then?
I am the token American of the group, or the Yank, as they give me a hard time about quite a bit. But I am. I'm from New York City, and Jonathan Shallett heard about me while I was playing Curly in the first national tour of the London Revival of Oklahoma, and was invited to come over here and meet with these fine gentlemen, and then just was lucky enough to come over here.
Such a huge catalogue then of sort of musical theatre favourites to choose from for your album. How did you go about choosing them?
But it was tough, wasn't it?
Yeah, yeah. That was very tough. That was a really hard part of the process because we started off workshopping about 60 different songs.
Did you argue? Did you fight?
We had scraps.
Tooth and nail.
Yeah, he did. He took me down.
I think the general thing was once our theatre had been formed, it was kind of creating our own sound. Many songs were able to work within that sound, and I think we've
fundamentally, because Teatro is focused on the musicals, we wanted for our first album to get the really popular show tunes from Phantom of the Opera, from Les Miserables, and from West Side Story.
We're going to see you at the Royal Variety Performance on television this weekend. Where you, I mean, you know, you met the Queen. You're doing pretty well. How was it?
Not bad. It was. An absolute tremendous honor to be there. We were performing with, you know, amazing performers such as Bon Jovi and Seal and Catherine Jenkins, and to meet the Queen of England, I think all the guys would agree, was just probably one of those definitive moments in your life that you will never forget.
Incredible.
It was a tremendous honor for us.
Mm. It's quite a stretch, Bon Jovi, to you lot, Teatro. Yeah.
I wonder who
Her Majesty preferred.
Well, she spoke to us for quite a long time, I think.
You got the nod then.
It was a great honour in the end because everybody, all the cast got to sing Let It Be right at the end of the show as well.
Excellent.
Yeah, and then all the members of Teatro were given microphones, and you know, we were singing with Bon Jovi. So we can say we sang with Bon Jovi.
Stephen, Simon, Andrew, Jeremiah. See, I can do it back.
There you go.
Thank you all very much.
Thank you very much for having us.
Thank you.